Here we are studying chapter number 2, Nutrition in Animals of 7th Standard Science Subject. Right? So, in our first lecture, we have just introduced the chapter. We go through what is nutrition. Okay, what are the types of nutrition, that is heterotrophic and autotrophic. Then we studied about what is digestion. So let's recall, digestion means the complex components of the food are converted into simpler one, right? So this process is known as digestion. The process of digestion is different in different animals. Okay, so today we have to start with digestion in human beings, means how the digestion takes place in our body. What are the various organs which are involved in this digestion? What happens when we eat food and where it goes? All this we have to learn today, right? So let's start with our topic, that is digestion in human beings. As we all know, we require food. Okay, we require food for energy, we require food for our daily activities, right? So this food, when we eat from our mouth, where does it go? What happens to it? Okay, that all we have to learn here. So let's start. As we take the food passes through various organs, okay, and it passes through a specific path which is known as our digestive system. So the food passes through a continuous canal. Continuous canal means a particular path or particular way, okay, which is known as canal. So continuous canal known as the alimentary canal. So when we eat the food, food passes through various organs. Every time food passes through various organs, and this various organs form a canal, a path, and this canal is known as an alimentary canal. It is also known as digestive tract. So here it is written, it is also known as digestive tract. The canal starts, as I told you, when we eat the food with our mouth. Okay, so the canal starts at our mouth, that is known as buccal cavity or buccal cavity. Both pronunciation are perfect, right? So the canal starts at buccal cavity and ends at anus. So buccal cavity is the mouth, okay, from where we intake the food, and anus is the organ from where we just remove the undigested, unwanted food, right? So the alimentary canal starts with buccal cavity and ends at anus. Different compartments of the alimentary canal. So let's discuss which are the different compartments. Okay, when food passes through this alimentary canal, which different compartments are there through which the food passes? So first one, as we know, buccal cavity, or we can also say mouth, the buccal cavity. Second is esophagus, or we can say the food pipe. Okay, when we were in lower standard, we were using this word food pipe. But now we are in 7th standard. So, we must have to remember this word, that is esophagus. Just see the spelling of esophagus. Here O is silent. So, be particular in remembering the word esophagus or food pipe. Then next compartment is stomach. Okay, then small intestine, लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन विथ एंड्स इन रेक्टम. ओके, सो रेक्टम इज द कंपार्टमेंट और वी कैन से द पार्ट ऑफ अ लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन वेयर द अनडाइजेस्टेड वेस्ट इज और अनडाइजेस्टेड फूड इज स्टोर्ड, राइट. एंड द लास्ट वन एज वी डिस्कस दैट कैनल स्टार्ट्स एंड एंड्स विथ व्हाट. सो द लास्ट वन दैट इज द एंड ऑफ द कैनाल इज एनस. सो दीज आर द वेरियस कंपार्टमेंट्स. लेट्स रिकॉल द ब्यूकल कैविटी, द इसोफेगस और फूड पाइप, द स्टमक, द स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन, द लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन विच एंड्स इन रेक्टम एंड लास्ट वन इज एनस. सो नाउ लेट्स सी वेयर दीज पार्ट्स आर सिचुएटेड इन आवर बॉडी. लुक एट द डायग्राम. ओके, यू हैव टू ड्रॉ दिस डायग्राम, राइट. सो जस्ट लुक हियर, दिस इज द डायग्राम ऑफ ह्यूमन डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम. वी हैव टू ड्रॉ इट एंड लेबल इट. सो लेट्स सी ईच ऑर्गन वन बाय वन. फर्स्ट माउथ. ओके, सो विथ द माउथ और ब्यूकल कैविटी वी आर जस्ट टेकिंग द फूड. देन हियर यू कैन सी सलाइवरी ग्लैंड्स. देन व्हाट आर दिस सलाइवरी ग्लैंड्स? सलाइवरी ग्लैंड्स आर नथिंग बट द ग्लैंड्स विच प्रोड्यूसेस सलाइवा. ओके, वी नो दैट देर इज कंटिन्यूअस प्रोडक्शन ऑफ सलाइवा अकर्स इन अवर माउथ वेदर वी आर स्लीपिंग और नॉट. ओके, कंटिन्यूअस प्रोडक्शन ऑफ सलाइवा अकर्स बाय द सलाइवरी ग्लैंड्स प्रेजेंट एट द अपर साइड एज वेल एज एट द बेस ऑफ अवर माउथ. ओके, देन नेक्स्ट इज, ओके, हियर यू कैन सी दिस इज, यस यू आर राइट, इसोफेगस और अदर नेम इज फूड पाइप, बट हियर वी विल रिमेंबर इसोफेगस इटसेल्फ. ओके, देन द अदर ग्लैंड, एज आई टोल्ड यू दिस इज द ग्लैंड नॉट द ऑर्गन. ओके, व्हाट इज द डिफरेंट बिटवीन दिस टू इज ऑर्गन्स आर देयर इन अवर बॉडी फ्रॉम विच द फूड पासिस. ओके, बट ग्लैंड्स आर देयर इन आवर बॉडी बट फूड डू नॉट पास थ्रू दिस ग्लैंड्स. ग्लैंड्स विल ओनली प्रोड्यूस सम सिक्रीशन, ओके, सम लिक्विड विच विल हेल्प द फूड टू डाइजेस्ट, राइट. सो अनदर ग्लैंड विच इज नोन एज लीवर, राइट. देन दिस इज जे शेप्ड ऑर्गन, एज वी ऑल नो दिस इज अ स्टमक. देन अगेन अनदर ग्लैंड दैट इज पैनक्रियास. हियर ऑल्सो फूड विल नॉट पास थ्रू इट. It is just a gland which secretes something, which produces some liquid or digestive juice, which help the food to get digested. Then the food enters into small intestine. Okay, so as we all know, this is small intestine. Then next is large intestine and here we have discussed that large intestine ends in rectum, right. So this is, we can say that this is rectum where the undigested food is stored, right. So rectum and the last one from where the undigested food or the waste material will be removed out from our body, and that is anus. Okay, so here are the various organs and glands of digestive system. So here we can say that salivary glands, liver and pancreas, these three are various glands which produces digestive juices which help the food to get digested. So whenever food enters in our mouth, from our mouth, food goes into esophagus, then stomach, then to small intestine, then from it it goes to large intestine. The undigested food will be stored in the rectum and then it will pass out from our body through anus. So this is our digestive system. Now let's study each and every compartment of our digestive system in detail. As we know that when we take the food, food enters from our mouth. So the first compartment of our digestive system is the buccal cavity and mouth. So first of all, as we know, the food enters, we take the food with our hands and it goes in our mouth. So this process of taking food inside our body is known as ingestion. Okay, so here it is written, the definition of ingestion is the process of taking food into the body is known as ingestion. Okay, ingestion means to take the food inside our body. So when we take the food inside our body, okay, it goes in our mouth. Our mouth contains mainly two things, the tongue and the teeth. As we know, each teeth in our mouth is rooted in separate socket in gums. So we must have to take care about our gums as well as our teeth. You might remember that at the age of 6 or 7, your teeth fell down. Okay, when you get birth, you don't have teeth. Then at the age of 2 to 3 years, you get some teeth, right? These teeth are known as milk teeth. At the age of 6 or 7, each milk teeth fell down and in the place of this milk teeth, new teeth come and these teeth are known as permanent teeth. So we must have to care about our permanent teeth, as we know that if permanent teeth fell, then we do not get any teeth, right? So we have to do brush. We have to brush our teeth daily twice. So it will care our teeth, right? So as we know, each tooth appears different and their function is also different. So let's see what happens. So our teeth vary means different in their appearance. Appearance means how they are looking, right? And their functions. So here I have made a table. Okay, here types of teeth and their functions, right? So we know that in our mouth there are four types of teeth. So which are these four types? Let's see. First is incisors. Incisors are also known as cutting and biting teeth. So obviously their function is to cut and bite the food. When we smile, these incisors can be seen, right? So these incisors are four in upper jaw and four in lower jaw, right? We know that our mouth has two jaws, upper jaw and lower jaw, right? So number of incisors we can write here is 8. 4 in upper jaw and 4 in lower jaw. What is their function? Their function is to cut and bite the food. If I give you an apple, then you will use the incisors to bite an apple, right? Then next two incisors are canines. So canines are also known as tearing teeth. So when any eat the flesh, what they do? They tear the flesh, right? So this tearing teeth are also present in our mouth, that are two in upper jaw and two in lower jaw. So total number of canines are four. Then next is premolars. Okay, premolars are after canines. Means first incisors, then canines, then premolars. So they are also known as grinding teeth. When we have to grind the food, means we have to convert the food into small pieces, then it can be done by premolars, right? So premolars, in each jaw we have four premolars, to this side, to this side. Then in lower jaw also, to this side and to this side. So total 8 numbers of premolars are present in our mouth. Okay. Then last one is molars. Molars means they are also known as chewing teeth. When we eat the food, we chew the food properly. We know that our elders continuously tell us that chew the food properly, then swallow it, otherwise the digestion will not take place properly, right? So for chewing we have molars in our mouth. So total 6 molars are present in our upper jaw as well as in our lower jaw. 3 this side, 3 this side, again 3 this side in lower jaw, and 3 this side in lower jaw. So total the number of molars are 12. So if you count the total number of teeth present in an adult human body is 8 plus 4, 12, 12 plus 8, 20, and 20 plus 12, 32. So as we know, in our mouth total 32 teeth are present. So in the buccal cavity and mouth we have discussed about teeth. The another thing or muscular organ which is present in our mouth is tongue. As we all know, tongue is a muscular organ. Okay, so what is the function of tongue? Why God has given us tongue? Because of two reasons. Number one, it can taste the food. As we know, there are taste buds which are present on the surface of the tongue, and due to this taste buds, we can generally know which taste we are having in the food. And the second function is the tongue will mix the saliva with our food and make the food easy to swallow. Right? So this is about our tongue. Then another thing or gland which we can say present in our mouth, that is salivary glands. As I told you when we have learned about this figure, that salivary glands produces saliva. So continuous production of saliva occurs in our mouth by salivary glands. This salivary glands help the starch which is present in our food to convert it into sugar. So we can say that the digestion of our food will start in our mouth. Okay, in mouth what is get digested? Starch. Starch converts into sugar by the saliva. Right, so students, this is all about the first compartment of digestive system, that is the buccal cavity and the mouth. In our next lecture, we will discuss about esophagus or the food pipe. Till that, be safe at home and try to draw the figure of human digestive system. Thank you.
आभार।